It's day 194, 2016, and today we have an announcement from Huawei and a number of leaks. This is Phone Arena Daily. Let's begin. Huawei has announced a new phone, and it's called the Honor 8. That's what you can see here. It's basically a mid-range to high-end phone, which comes in the price range of 20 to 25,000 rupees. And it kind of competes directly with the likes of the Xiaomi Mi 5 and OnePlus 3, and even to an extent the upcoming iPhone 7, which is going to be a smaller, not the iPhone 7 Plus. So this is the Honor 8, which has a dual camera setup at the back, 12 megapixels on each sensor, and the pixel size is 1.76 microns, which is pretty big. In fact, it's just shy smaller than the HTC Ultra Pixel, which was 2 microns. Now imagine the size of this. So two cameras at the back, and it has 4GB of RAM. It's powered by the Kirin 950 processor along with the co-processor, of course, for graphics. So yeah, more details in the description below. Check it out. Let's now start with the leaks. This is the Meizu MX6, which is supposedly going to succeed the Meizu MX5. And you can see that the design is very similar to the Meizu Pro 6 that was launched a while back. So this phone is also going to be very similarly placed in the market in competition to the Xiaomi Mi 5s, the OnePlus 3, the one we saw, the Honor 8, and a lot of devices that occupy the 20 to 25,000 range. So this is going to have a deca-core processor, that's the Helio X20 that's already been announced for this phone, and also it's going to have the 4GB of RAM, a 12 megapixel camera at the back, but this time just a one camera unit. But yes, this is the Meizu MX6, let's move on to the next one. This is reportedly the Redmi Note 4, and as you can see from the picture, it supposedly has two cameras at the back. So this is a growing trend because iPhone 7 is expected to have dual cameras at the back. It's very surprising that Samsung hasn't done this yet. Huawei has been doing this for a while, and HTC, well, they started it all, but they had a different idea about it. So all these dual camera leaks are getting out now from China, and the Redmi Note 4 too could have a dual camera setup, but I'm not really sure because the Redmi Note 3 has a fingerprint sensor at the back, and at the same place this one has a camera unit, so this might be a Photoshop too, but the body looks real and I'm not so sure about the camera unit. So sound off what you think in the comment section below. And finally we have this. These are the Android Wear watches that are part of the Google Nexus program outed by Android Police. They have these recreations out too, and they say that they're very, very close to what the prototypes look like. So the UI, you can see, it has changed a lot and changed for the good. Android Wear is evolving, and if Google jumps in, it could be pretty interesting. So as we reported earlier, Angelfish and Swordfish are the two different names for the smartwatches. Apparently Angelfish is now the bigger one and the Swordfish is a smaller one. You can see that Angelfish is quite chunkier, has a larger dial and has three buttons, including a crown, possibly a crown. And the next one has just the crown. So both are like possibly the male and female counterparts. I'm not sure how Google is going to place these in the market, but they seem very interesting. And I'd love to know what you think. That's the point of discussion today. What do you think about these Android Wear renders, and do you think Google will be able to revive Android Wear's interest by jumping into hardware? Let us know what you think in the comment section below, and check out the deal of the day also in the link. Check out all the stories in case you need additional information, and that's about it for today's show. Thanks for watching. We'll catch you later with more technology news.